on, let me get the, there we go. Carrots or pig noses. Rock. The pig noses, all right, that's interesting. Imagine how long he's been in there. Oh man, I hate that bastard. I really hate that bastard. I think it's time to leave this place. Oh, fuck me! Fuck me! Fuck me! Fuck me! No, 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 no. Holy shit. Oh, God! Shit, shit, shit. Like right here. Oh my god. I get killed just now? Oh my god, I hate that guy. I really hate that guy. I've only died once, so... Ooh, man alive. Did I put you down there? You're going back down to that pool. Oh. Oh. Okay. Oh. The water's turned to blood. Oh. A dead guy being molesting us at a late. What are you doing? Good dead sir. What are you doing to this poor statue? Well, I guess I can say it's time to leave this awful, awful place. With pus and blood squirting down at the walls. Oh my god, I hate that guy. I really hate that guy. The second death caused by his damn curiosity. I already know that. Oh, bug. Nice. Would you kindly get off my face?
5th of July, 1839. Today, I went to the university looking for answers. I was able to sneak into Herbert's office and pick up an address book along with some relevant textbooks. Professor Taylor at the Faculty of History was very helpful, and I managed to approach the subject of the orbs. The most interesting aspect was the prevalent trace they had left in our culture. The mythic orbs may, in fact, have inspired the Globus Cruciger, which so many royal regalia holds to this day. In ancient times, the orbs were held by priests as a symbol of the sun and its power. As I was leaving, I overheard a disturbing conversation. Sir William Smith, the geologist, was killed last night. Less than a fortnight had passed since I'd asked for his expertise. I know it's silly, but I can't help feeling responsible somehow.
You murdering bastard. What's this thing? Okay. I know what that is. I think it's 8 and 8. So 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright.